Coming up on this episode, I promise you, you will be blessed as well as uplifted. We encourage you to stay tuned because you're watching Perspectives with yours truly, Darren Hyme.
What's on your mind?
Let him know.
What's on your mind? What's on your mind?
Anything relevant to life you bring it to the table. Whether you make a move solo or a movement with a stable. No fables to speak on your decisions. Cause in the long run it's your voice, your views, your vision. Keeping it real with many messages for you to know. This ain't radio but DJ runs the show. Entertainment he rocks it, politics he locks it. The host with the most would handle any topic. Don't forget to share your perspective which shines a light. Cause it might make a difference in someone else's life.
What's your perspective? Express what's in your heart and your mind. Share your perspective.
And hello, welcome to another exciting edition of Perspectives. I'm your host, Darren Hyme, and we want to remind you that you're welcome to share your perspective with us. All you got to do is send us your comments to perspectives@bronxnet.org, or you can log on to our website, www.bronxnet.org/perspectives. And there you can also watch, share some videos, or leave comments on your favorite shows. And we, of course, want to hear from you and see your responses as well. Well, for the past 28 years, the McDonald's Gospel Fest has been celebrating gospel music and bringing together some of the best and most inspirational gospel artists. This past Father's Day weekend, the 2011 Gospel Fest was held at the Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. Our Arlene Makoko was there. She has the story.
They came from as far away as Japan and as near as the Bronx with one thing in common, to deliver their best performance at the 28th Annual Gospel Fest held at the Prudential Center in Newark and just to have fun. Nia Soyima from the Bronx was just one among 80 finalists competing, chosen out of a pool of 40,000 performing in one of 9 different categories, including Best Adult Soloist, Instrumentalist, Rapper, and more.
What was going through my mind is that at least I'm blessed enough to just minister to his children, so I'm very grateful for that opportunity, really. For him to be able to use me, so I'm really excited about that.
Among those competing alongside Nia, Nigel Lassiter from Paterson, New Jersey.
I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody, nobody great.
Meanwhile, backstage was abuzz as performers shuttled through, taking quick breaks before cameras, proving to everyone why they got as far as they had. These steppers are from Miller Evangelical Church in Brooklyn.
What's it like to perform in that Prudential Center there?
Nerve-wracking, but yeah.
It was fun.
Yeah.
I enjoyed myself.
Gives you, like, you're enthused about it when you get up there. It's just, it happens, and you just got to give your all and just go out there and do it because you know why you're doing it.
Then there were the choirs. By the time the competition was over, the crowd was ready for the evening's main speaker, Bishop T.D. Jakes, and gospel heavy hitters Donnie McClurkin and Bishop Hezekiah Walker. They were joined by Vicki Winans and Newark native Sissy Houston. Kirk Franklin was the last performer before the winners were announced.
Many of the performers said it so well, the McDonald's Gospel Fest is a competition, but it's also about coming together as a community to uplift each other and to celebrate. For Bronxnet, this is Arlene Makoko.
So And thank you, Arlene. And uplifting it was indeed. And when we come back, we're going to talk to the man who's been the driving force behind this extraordinary festival. Plus, I promised you that you'd be blessed and uplifted after this. So we want you to stay with us, and we'll tell you how. Don't go away. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
So here are the keys. Congratulations. It's officially yours. I'm sure you'll have many happy years here. Except for you, because you'll be gone 3 years from now, struck down by the same disease that got your father. So you won't be around for them. And sadly, it could have been detected early with a simple test, but you didn't have it. Okay, who wants to check out the backyard?
For a list of tests every man should have, go to ahrq.gov.
There is also a very attractive extended warranty option that includes free service and parts for the next 5 years. But there's no need for you to get that. You failed to get the test you needed at the doctor that would have detected disease early enough where it could have been treated. So you won't be around in 2 years to see him grow up, which means the warranty would be useless. Okay, sign here, please.
For a list of tests every man should have, go to ahrq.gov.
Welcome back to Perspectives. There you saw some of the sights and sounds from McDonald's Gospel Fest 2011 and Bishop Hezekiah Walker. We encourage you, if you want to find out more information about us here at Perspectives, be sure to check us out, www.bronxnet.org/perspectives. Well, joining us now on set is the one, the Emmy Award-winning producer and director of the McDonald's Gospel Fest, Mr. Curtis Farrow, and we welcome him back to the show, and thank you
for coming back.
We had you before.
Had me before, and I'm excited to be back here.
Come back after. Yes. Now that it's all over, how do you feel?
Fantastic. Or as I tell my folks, God-tastic. We had a great time. It was a great celebration, all inspiring, full gospel, all gospel. You know, the great thing about this year, this is the first year in 8 years that we had an all gospel lineup.
Wow.
Without a pop icon being a part of the Gospel Fest. Mm-hmm. And we sold more tickets than ever. And it was just an inspirational, very spiritual time. We had a great time.
And you did extraordinarily well, because normally the event is usually held at Madison Square Garden.
We did. It's normally at Madison Square Garden, but the venue we're in now, it's actually larger than mm-hmm. the garden. And it was amazing. It was so amazing to see the stars come out and see all the people, and they were in awe. Wow. I mean, Donnie was backstage saying to me, oh my God, I hope they're filming this so that they can see all of these folks just having a good time. And everybody, you know, my staff wore buttons that said peace, love, and joy. And everyone really came to the table with peace, love, and joy. I can't, even if you ask me, was there a negative? There was none.
Right.
Because we were so in the spirit of peace, love, and joy. It was a great time.
It takes about a year to put this together,
right? It does. We started on next year's yesterday.
Oh, okay. So it takes about a year to put together.
Yes.
Done in a few hours.
Done in 5 hours, yes.
And talk about that feeling of actually the year of preparation just to get to this point.
Well, the preparation of getting to the point and working with McDonald's, who's been in the business for 28 years, it is like no other. I always tell everyone, because you are working on it and you know that it's coming, and you think you have a lot of time, mm-hmm. but it is here so quickly. And then once it's here on the day of, like I have to tell you that Saturday went so fast that I was like, oh my God, we did all that preparation and it went so quick. Mm-hmm. But folks and kids and youth, I tell everybody out there, it's hard work. It's not about how long it lasts.
Right.
It's about the work that you put into it. And we put our all in to that one day. And we feel great about it. I mean, the next day I woke up, I was great. I have to tell you that the stars woke me up because each one was calling me saying, oh man, what a great time. Wasn't that fun? Because everyone was still on a godly high after the event, which was fantastic.
Talk to us about this, because here you go. You have a wonderful combination because you have these gospel stars.
Yes.
But then yet and still, it's also mixed with the fact of local, you know, local ministry talent and things of that nature. And you're able to fuse these together.
Yes. And oh my God, our local talent this year was fantastic. But Darren, you know, it's not only the local talent. We also have talent from around the world. We had a choir called the Silvertones from Barbados. We had the Don't Give Up Japan Choir from Japan. You know, we have choirs and groups and praise dancers and steppers. They come from all across the world now. We have truly gone international. But the New York contingency was absolutely fantastic. And the kids, I mean, the youth, they were on display in such a major way. And just think about it, that they were able to be in front of 18,000 people. Mm-hmm. You know, where else can they go and do what God gave them and use their gift in front of all of these people? And that's a part of the reason McDonald's created the program, you know, was to take the kids from out of the church and give them the same opportunities that the pop, the rock stars have in the same venues. And I have to tell you, it works like magic.
I was having a conversation because people were talking about Sunday's Best, and they talk about American Idol and stuff like this.
Yes.
And I was telling people that McDonald's Gospel Fest has actually given people that stage.
Absolutely.
In a major format for years before you even saw this.
Those were created from Gospel Fest, believe it or not. Gospel Fest, I heard from the guys from American Idol before they even started American Idol. They wanted to talk to me about what we do. And the same thing with Sunday's Best. All of those are created from the Gospel Fest. The Gospel Fest was the first. Everybody else is doing it now, but it was the first, and it is still a branded, godly entity that I must say that grows and grows and grows. I'm amazed at what we do and how it works myself, because it extends so far into the community. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's the one thing that I think that's the missing piece, is that this really is a community event. It's an event where all of the community comes together and we just have a great time.
Well, absent Sunday's Best, let's look at Sunday's Best. Absent Sunday's Best, in the tri-state area, there is really nothing that really brings together gospel music the way and performances and local talent the way the Gospel Fest does.
No, nothing at all. We are it. There are others who have tried, but you know what the problem is? Everyone who comes in and they try it, they always try to compete. Mm-hmm. So they always say, we're going to try to do what the Gospel Fest does, and we're going to try to be around the same time. You can't do it. There's 28 years of equity. The same thing happened with Verizon. They all come in, we're going to get it. They don't understand what we do. We've been working in the community for 28 years.
Right.
You got to build a base. You have to have a base in the Bronx. Mm-hmm. You got to have a base in Brooklyn. You got to have a base in Jersey. You got to have a base in Connecticut. You can't just come to the tri-state and think that it's going to just be a winner overnight. We don't operate that way. We are totally a community. And it's so funny because around the country, when they talk about the New York tri-state area, people think that we are fragmented. Mm-hmm. But in actuality, we are not. We are very much a community, but we're just a big body.
Mm-hmm. And most of all, you can't break down favor.
Can't break down favor. The favor of God, there's nothing like it. And as T.D. Jakes always says, favor ain't fair.
And you've definitely got favor right here in the tri-state area.
Absolutely.
And across the world.
Absolutely.
So you said this, and let me go back to this.
Yes.
You said just the other day.
Yes.
It was yesterday. Mm-hmm. You got started on working for next year?
We started working on next year yesterday. Yes, we did. because what we do is, even at the Gospel Fest, we ask people to Facebook me to let me know what stars they want to be on the show. Mm-hmm. Because that's always one of the biggest pieces of the puzzle, is because so many times we use a lot of the same stars, but because we know we're going to get what we expect out of them, and then we put some new pieces in. Mm-hmm. And so we started on that yesterday. We also started talking about the venue. We also started talking about what our set would look like and what the lights would look like. And, you know, even here, even in this studio, people that are listening, they can't imagine how much work goes into putting a show like this together.
Right.
You know, and it takes a lot of behind the scenes work.
What do you want to see happen next year? I mean, obviously, after coming fresh out of this, mm-hmm. obviously you say, okay, there's a lot of things that you're happy about, but I know on the inside that, there's a, maybe we could just do, what's that one thing that maybe you want to see done?
Well, my biggest problem, and my staff gets on my case, is I like to be as inclusive as possible. I always tell them we're in the business of encouragement, mm-hmm. that we're in the business of encouraging people. So when folks audition, we auditioned over 40,000 people. So when we audition folks, I want them all to be a part of it, mm-hmm. which is impossible.
Right.
And so the biggest problem for me, or the biggest, I would have to say, thing I have to work on is that I only can use so many of them.
Because you gotta learn how to say no.
I gotta learn how to say no. Yes, I would say even more than I have already, because otherwise the event would last from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. It already is from 4 p.m. to 11 p.m.
Right.
You know, so I would have to say if I had to work on one thing, it would be that. And being as inclusive as we can, but with less people.
And now here's the thing. A lot of people think that McDonald's Gospel Fest is all that you do.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Sad misconception.
Yes, yes.
Let's fill the people in on what else goes on.
Well, I produce and direct Broadway show tours, national tours. I do Ain't Misbehavin', which is the most successful black musical to ever run on Broadway. I do Sophisticated Ladies, which is a show that's in honor of the great Duke Ellington. Mm-hmm. I do Five Guys Named Mo, which we do all over the world, which is a fantastic show. We also do Your Arms Too Short to Box with God. And we're also in the discussions right now, or in the planning stage of doing a movie of Your Arms Too Short to Box with God. So there's a lot going on. Yes, and I do much more. Plus, I own an agency. The agency Irving Street is actually a PR ad agency and entertainment agency.
Well, Curtis, I know you're a very busy man.
Yeah, I love it though. I love it.
We love
when God gives me my rest.
That's it.
I'm gonna need it.
That's it. And we thank you for coming by and sharing with us.
Oh, it's such a pleasure to be here.
And hopefully, before we get ready for next year, you know, and if you guys want to come back and talk about some of the other shows,
hey, I want you to be on it next year. You got to come and be a part.
I will be glad to.
Yes,
I'll be glad to. Good to
have
you.
That's a formal invitation in front of all.
And we accept in front of all. There it is. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Curtis Farrow, our guest here. And well, guess what? We promised this now. If you weren't able to make it to the 2011 McDonald's Gospel Fest, well, we want you to do this. Set your DVRs right now, because thanks to the friends from Irving Street and the McDonald's Gospel Fest, BronxNet was given exclusive access. And for the remainder right here on BronxNet, the 2011 McDonald's Gospel Fest highlights will be coming right at you.
Come on, if you believe that it's already done, come on, for your family, for your children, for your finances, you want to give him a praise right there. I got my brother Isaac Curry. Y'all receive him. God bless him right here.
I believe the family will get better. And I believe God will provide. I believe the promise that he made. Oh, I believe, I know it's already done.
Listen, the blessing is yours. Oh, come on, God's already pre-approved your boy. Come on, somebody, listen, say it.
And I believe that I will survive. Oh, I believe God is able. Oh, I believe. I know that it's already done.
Listen, the Bible says that if any two of us can agree on anything, Jesus say, my Father will do it for you in heaven. And y'all, sometimes I've had situations where I couldn't even pray for myself. So today, y'all, I came from Houston to agree with you that it's getting ready to get better. And right now, I want you to give your problems an expiration date and say, devil, it's over. That I've been crying over long enough. That I've been worried about it long enough. That I've been struggling long enough. If that's you, somebody stand to your feet and give God a praise and just say,
I'm
like it better.
Yeah. Yeah. Say you can't handle it. You gotta give it to Jesus. Anybody know who work it out?
Yes, you will.
Let me see you wave your hand.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do believe. Yes, I do believe.
It's already better. It's already fixed for you. Listen, you never know what somebody's going through. And we are family tonight, y'all. Just tell somebody, God's gonna fix it. God's gonna work it out for you. Come on, whatever it is.
God's gonna do it.
God's gonna do it.
God's gonna do it.
Yes, he will.
God's gonna do it.
Anybody believe it?
Yes, he
is.
Help me say I'm grateful. Come on.
I'm grateful.
Y'all help us.
I'm grateful.
I'm grateful.
I'm grateful.
I'm waiting for everybody in this room to say it. Let the devil hear you.
I'm grateful.
Let me hear you say it.
I'm grateful.
I hear you. I'm grateful.
I'm grateful.
Say it so everybody on your row can hear you. Say I'm grateful.
I'm grateful.
Come on, say I'm grateful.
I'm grateful.
So grateful,
so grateful,
hey,
so grateful,
I'm grateful. maker.
He's a way 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 maker.
Say he's a door opener.
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 He's a provider.
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 He's a way maker.
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 He's a provider.
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 He's a deliverer.
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 Strong 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 deliverer.
He's a way maker.
He's a way maker.
He is a way maker.
He's a way maker.
He makes a way.
He's a way maker.
He made a way for anybody.
He's a way maker.
He's a healer.
He's a healer.
He's a doctor that's never lost a patient.
He's a healer.
He's a bomb in Gilead.
He's a healer.
He's a bomb in Gilead.
He's a healer.
He's a provider.
He's a provider.
I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
He's a provider.
I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
He's a provider.
I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
He's a provider.
And I've got a feeling.
I've got a feeling.
I don't have time to suck up on the bus here. I don't have time to sing songs like Speed to My Heart. Holy Spirit, I don't have time to sing. Give me the words that will bring you.
Well, there you saw some of the highlights from 2011 McDonald's Gospel Fest. We encourage you, get on the calendar early because 2012 will come right before you know it. How many of you know time flies, especially when you're having fun? Well, Well, don't forget to log on to our website at www.bronxnet.org/perspectives and share about your favorite episode. If you want to rate this episode, go ahead and rate it. And remember, you can share your perspective with somebody else because guess what? It just might make a difference in someone else's life. For all of us here on the Set of Perspectives, our producer, Curlew Burton, we thank you for joining us. And once again, a special thanks to Mr. A. Curtis Farrell and McDonald's Gospel Fest for this exclusive access. And most of all, a wonderful show at the McDonald's Gospel Fest. Take care. We'll see you soon.